Hey guys, welcome to the Skolo Online YouTube channel, the channel that is all about learning. In this channel, I make a lot of videos on how to create your own website, how to create your own e-commerce or WooCommerce website and start making money online by selling products online. If you're new to this channel, please remember to hit the subscribe button. You can find it at the bottom of the video and just hit subscribe. Please like this video if you like my content and remember to leave me a comment below. Talk to me, let me know what you like about the videos, what you don't like about the videos, what I can do to improve on these videos. And if you're new to the channel as well, if you go to the description, there is video timestamps available for you. If you want to jump ahead to certain sections of the video, if you don't want to watch the entire video, please feel free to utilize those video timestamps and follow us on our social media channels. We've got a Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram page, and let's start learning. So the first thing that we're going to go through is obviously the web hosting itself and the different packages that are available for web hosting. On this channel, we discuss a lot about domains, but today I want to discuss a little bit on Afrihost as well, because I had a question once in the past, and a lot of people, I come across a lot of people that use Afrihost, and so let's go through the Afrihost hosting packages. If you go to the Afrihost website and you look under hosting, you will see that there is Linux web hosting and Windows web hosting. So basically what this is shared hosting, okay? So what Afrihost does is that they'll have one computer. And a computer will be represented by an IP address. An IP address is just the address where the computer is located on the World Wide Web, all right? Then that IP address could be whatever. It'd be like four numbers, you know, like 42-... whatever. And that IP address is a computer, and that computer could either have a Linux operating system on it or a Windows operating system on it. And then if you want to work with Linux, then you would use that. If you want to work with Windows, you would use that. But when you're doing web hosting, I think it doesn't really matter, because you're only going to be focused on the HTML and CSS files. That's all you need to read, unless if you're doing specialized type hosting where you're hosting certain programs that either run only on Linux or Windows, then you would be concerned about which operating system you're using. But that's not for this discussion. Now, the key here is the word shared hosting. What shared hosting means is that Afrihost can sell me, a Bertha, space on that computer. So they'll say to me, like, let's click the Windows one, right? And if you click on the Windows one, you will see that there's a certain specifications. So they will sell you, Bertha, in this specific case, 1.5 gig of space. So you might find that the computer has 40 gigs of space, 100 gigs, I don't know, but they're only giving me 1.5 gigs, okay? Somebody else might come along, Peter, and buy also one hosting package, and then they'll sell Peter 1.5 gig on the same computer. And then somebody else, Mary, comes along and wants another 1.5 gig, and they'll sell Mary 1.5 gig on the same computer. So they could use one computer, and they could sell different people different amounts of spaces on that computer, and you all share that IP address in that computer. That is called shared hosting, okay? Shared hosting is sufficient for a lot of website design, especially WordPress, okay? Because WordPress only needs like a database, and you know, you're gonna put in your CSS files as well, and you know, you're pretty much sorted and everything just runs on its own, okay? So shared hosting is sufficient for WordPress websites, and a lot of the tutorials we've done here, we have used shared hosting. But the important key to note, and what I sort of explain to my clients all the time, is when it comes to hosting, cheaper is not always better. You need to go through your specifications of what your hosting provider is providing you for the amount of money you're paying them. So this is 89 rands that you're paying per month, right? But have a look at this. Setup is free. The domain is free for the first year. Email accounts, you get 50 database, da, 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 da. And then everybody thinks, oh my gosh, I'm going to have 50 email accounts on this. I'm good to go. But they fail to note that you actually only get 1.5 gigs of space. 1,500 megabytes. That's not a lot. Maybe you can put one website on this, but you're definitely not going to have 50 email accounts on 1.5 gigs of space. All right. So you need to take note of that. Perhaps you might need this one that gives you 2 gigs. But keep in mind, if you're putting together a e-commerce website that has images, that has all the you know, requirements and all the plugins that you need for e-commerce. You know, you need a lot of, you know, intricacies and whatever, you know. And typically, the e-commerce websites that I build, if you're going to talk about 50 products upwards, you need at least 4 gigs or so of space. So for e-commerce properly working, and if you're going to install, for example, the theme that we installed where we went from CMS Masters, one of those nice themes, you're going to be needing about 4 gigs of space to be on the safe side just for the e-commerce website. So this is not even going to be sufficient. This is not going to be sufficient. Maybe you're going to be needing this package. So people look at the price, okay, and they go for like, oh no, I've got a hosting package. It's only like 59 rands. And they fail to notice that 59 rands for 1 gig. You won't even have 25 email accounts for 59 gigs. So every time you go for a hosting package, please pay close attention to the storage space that they're giving you, not these other things. You know, because you're going to look at 25 emails, you're going to look at the free domain, you're going to look at, oh, I get databases, I get all of these nice features, but then, oopsies, I only have 1 gig of space. 2 email accounts, that space is already taken, and definitely you won't be able to host a proper e-commerce website, right? So that's what I wanted to show you when it comes to shared hosting. And obviously, you know, domains as well has got shared hosting. But what I like about the domains shared hosting package, even the smallest one, at least you get 5 gigs of space for 89 rand. So compare 5 gigs of space, all right, with the 89 rand package here, 1.5 gig of space, to properly compare packages, not just you know, the price. Then the next thing that I want to discuss is what we call a cloud or VPS. Okay, everything is cloud hosting. Cloud basically means cloud is actually a very fancy word that sometimes gets confusing for me, somebody that's actually a technical person, because basically what this is somebody else's computer that's based somewhere else, and you're able to access that someone else's computer, all right? It's not really in the cloud. It is just hosted somewhere else, all right? So now I'm going to remove this word cloud, okay? This is a word used by people who don't understand technical terms. Let's talk about VPS hosting. Now, VPS hosting is... I'm going to go to domains, and I'm going to go under hosting there, and I'm going to go for VPS hosting to show you, to go into details about VPS hosting. Now, basically, VPS hosting is where they give you a dedicated IP. Remember we talked shared hosting, where you would have one big computer, and then they give you like only 1 gig of space in that one, in that big computer for you to be able to build your website. VPS hosting is where you buy your own VPS machine to do whatever you want with it. So basically, you buy your own server. And when you get VPS hosting, you basically can configure that server any way that you want with your operating system on it. And then you can host like multiple websites on it. You can host databases. You can host anything you want. You have a computer that's sitting there for you to do. So I can go to Apple Store and buy this computer, this MacBook, right? And this computer is mine. And I bought it for like a couple of thousand rands, and I can do whatever I want. I have like 120 gig of space in here, you know, for me to work with it. VPS hosting is basically the same thing, but instead of you buying a computer, you are renting a computer space. So you go to domains, for example, and you say, I want you to rent me one VPS machine, one CPU core that has 1 gig of memory, 25 gigs of space, 500 gigs of traffic. This is like, you know, data, for example. And then they give you that VPS machine, right? And then within that VPS machine, you can now do whatever you want with it. You can configure it any way you want. You can install your own operating system. You can install Windows on it. You can install Linux on it. You can install CentOS on it. You can install anything you want on it. And then you can use it for, you know, hosting programs, for hosting websites, for basically hosting just about anything. And the next tutorials that we're going to be working on in the future, we're going to be doing a lot of our work on VPS machines, because shared hosting gets limited. And if you want to build your own specialized type of databases, you know, then you're going to need to have a VPS machine. If you want to run like a Python program, if you want to run, you know, like a specialized program, you're going to need to sort of configure the machine the way that you want to configure it. So you need your own special machine. And we're going to go and do a lot of that. Hence, I'm showing you this video here today. Now, I think Afrihost has that as well. So if you went under hosting and you went into cloud hosting, for example, this is where you would be able to get a dedicated hosting machine. I think this is the one. I haven't never bought the Afrihost one, but I'm assuming this is this one here, where you, for 310 rand a month, you will get one CPU, 2 gigs of RAM, 100 gigs of HDD for 310 rand, and then you can do whatever you want and work on this. This is what we call VPS, or your own sort of dedicated server machine to work on. Now, this is what VPS hosting is. The next thing I want to discuss is DNS records, because this is actually why I made this video today, because I had to deal with Afrihost. One of my clients, you know, refuses to move from Afrihost, so I had to work with Afrihost for this client, and I was trying to get them to just create for me a subdomain, all right? So I call Afrihost, can you please create for me a subdomain, and on this subdomain, just add the DNS records to point to my IP address, because I'm building this, you know, whatever I'm building for the client on a different IP, and I just want the DNS records to point to this IP. And the person at Afrihost was just completely dumbfounded. He had no idea what I'm talking about, and this is supposed to be client support. So I'm going to discuss with you in this video what is DNS records and how you use DNS records to point to different locations, and you know, and how to build DNS records for your website. Okay, so normally when you go for something like you know, let's go back to hosting, and you go to web hosting, and you create a hosting package. You order this. They'll send you an email with your cPanel login. You're going to cPanel. We've done videos on this. You know, and then you go to cPanel. You just build your website. Everything works. All of that is already configured for you, your DNS records. You don't even have to worry about that. But let's say you wanted to do something specialized, like you wanted to now create a subdomain. And in that subdomain, you wanted to build some nice, you know, Python web application on it. And but you wanted to build it on a VPS machine. But that VPS machine is sitting somewhere else on a different IP address, because you bought a different IP for that. And now you want to still use the same, you know, hosting, because you don't want to buy another hosting. You want to use the same domain that you bought, but you want it to point to whatever. So now you have to go and start tinkering with DNS records, right? I've got this open, right, on DigitalOcean, right? DigitalOcean is a very, very nice platform where you can go and also create like VPS machine type hosting, you know, on things like they call droplets. Okay, and droplets are basically just cloud servers, small little cloud servers that you can start, you know, writing code or doing a lot of interesting things on, you know, and they're really affordable. I mean, they start from, I think, about $15 per droplet, and you can sort of like upgrade your droplets as you go along, as you need to do more and more fancy things on it. So I use DigitalOcean a lot, and I'm going to use it to explain the name servers, because I think they represent it in the most easiest way to understand when it comes to creating, like, not name servers, but DNS records, right? Now, the first type of DNS records is what we call the name server, okay? This is basic. When you create a domain for the first time, whether, let's say the domain is lacewigs.co.za, for example, and you create it on, you know, domains.co.za, domains.co.za will provide you with a name server to work from. If you don't want to use domains name server, like you are building stuff on DigitalOcean, you can use DigitalOcean name servers. So you can just call domain and say, you know what, guys, I'm going to change my NS records. I don't want to work with your name servers. I want to work with the name servers of DigitalOcean, because I'm going to be building my stuff on DigitalOcean. They'll be like, yeah, fine, sure. You can just go change your NS records on your domain. So you come here and you would find out from DigitalOcean what is their name servers, and then you would put those name servers there on that domain. And from when you change the NS records, it means on the World Wide Web, on the internet, okay, the internet will recognize the place where your domain is located at, as the name server for that will be based on the NS records that is on that domain, right? So no domain can work without NS records. The second thing that you need is the A record. That's the most important one after the NS records. The A record is basically the host of the IP, the IP of the host where your actual files of the website are based. So the files, remember, the files are your HTML and CSS files, whatever files it is that you're hosting. Where those files are based, that where your files are based, that IP address, all right, that is the IP address that you need to point the A record to. So when somebody goes to like www.yourdomain.co.za, the A record is going to point them to the IP address where your files are based, and you need to always define this on your DNS records. The next thing that you need to define, the CNAME is really optional, but it's always good to do it because in case somebody like enters www.yourdomain or whatever, you can then point them to the host of the domain. So basically what the CNAME does is that it just points, whatever the, the entry that would be entered, and it points it to the host, the A record or the host of the IP. Okay, so if somebody enters www.co.za, it will sort of associate that with documentation.co.za, and when it gets there, that A record will direct it to the IP, and then the person will be able to find the website. Okay, so this is basically what you need, and this is as simple as it is. So if you were hosting your website somewhere else, you would just need to change the A record. Okay, the name servers are always provided by the hosting provider, or unless if you have your own name servers, you can change that there.